Hello. One of the astrology of the one of the gonad is definitely asked in the astrology question. Definitely it is the question. So out of the two gonads, one is the testis. Testis is endocrine as well as a gonad. And ori in female is endocrine as well as gonad. So very sure one of the astrology slide of either testis or ori is being asked in anatomy paper second question number 3 for PHMS first. So in the anatomical point of view, as all of you know better how to write the astrology of a question, the introduction, anatomical introduction, then the actual macroscopic structure of that organ, then the applied anatomy, and one either TS or a microscopy, or both the diagrams you may draw, the testis, TS of the testis, and the microscopic anatomy of the testis. So testis is one of the gonad in male. It is suspended in a bag-like structure called as a scrotum. It is suspended organ. See, there are two testes, the right and left, and both the testes do not remain in one level. One is either low or one is high. They do not lie in same plane. The testes is oval in shape, and the weight of the testes is 10 to 14 grams. Then the diameter, see, the length is 4 centimeter vertical length, anterior posteriorly 2 centimeters. Then the anterior, the width is around 2.3 centimeters. The location, exactly location, the testis has two surfaces and all of these, the weight measurements, upper pole, lower pole. Then the parts of examination of a testis, it includes the appendix of the testis, then the appendix of the epididymis, head of the epididymis, ductus deferens, then the body of the sinus of the epididymis, and actually testis. See, in a TS of the testes will show outermost the skin is there, then the parietal layers, that is tunica vaginalis. Testes has three layers: tunica vaginalis, then tunica, first of all tunica albuginea, tunica vaginalis, and innermost layer of the testes is tunica vasculosa. So the 2 marks question is also asked from the testis, is what are the 3 layers of the testis: tunica albuginea, tunica vaginalis, and tunica vasculosa. In the interior of the testis, there are seminiferous tubulum, is a structural, and testis has a two. One is the endocrine cells and the functioning or parenchymal cells, cells of the sartori. They are responsible to secrete the other than the hormones. So the testis consists of the rete testis, then the mediastinal testis, then the seminiferous tubules, and the vas continuous as a epididymis and continuous with the vas deferens. So the first and important, the presenting parts: testis has upper end and lower end, 2 borders, anterior and posterior, 2 surfaces, medial and lateral surfaces, 3 layers of the testis is there. The weight has already 10 to 15 grams. The 3 layers of the testis: tunica albuginea, tunica vaginalis, and tunica vasculosa. These are the 3 layers. The first one is the tunica albuginea. The tunica vaginalis consists of, first of all, tunica vaginalis. It has visceral layer and parietal layer. The visceral layer covers all the aspects of testis except most of the posterior aspect, posterior medially. It is reflected forward to the parietal layer. Posterior laterally, it is recessed between the lateral surface of the testis and epididymis upper body, forming the sinus of the epididymis. This layer then goes laterally to the posterior border of the epididymis to become continuous with parietal layer. These two layers form a closed vaginal sac. Now, tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea is a bluish white, thick fibrous membrane. It covers entire testes. At the posterior border, it projects into the interior of testes as a vertical incomplete septum called as a mediastinum testis. Now, numerous fibrous septa arise from the front and the sides of the mediastinum testis, radiate forward to the surface of the testis. These septa divide the testis into cone-shaped compartments called as the tubules of the testis. Each testis contains 200 to 300 lobules. Each lobule has 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules. See, 200 to 300. How many lobules are there in the testis? 200 to 300. And seminiferous tubule. Each lobule has 1 to 3 seminiferous tubule. Now, the innermost layer, that is tunica vasculosa. This tunica vasculosa lines the individual lobule of testis. It contains flexes of blood vessels and loose areolar tissue. Now, the tubular structures contain the seminiferous tubule. The total number of seminiferous tubules is around 400 to 600 seminiferous tubules. The lining of that seminiferous tubule is main important cells for secretions. Secretions, the hormones, main important hormone. Total number is 400. The near the apex of the lobule of seminiferous tubule lose their convolutions and join one another to form the 20 to 30 larger straight tubules. These enter the fibrous tissue of mediastinum testis and unite to form a network called as a rete testis. So mediastinum testis and rete testis. Then as its upper end, rete testis gives up 12 to 20 afferent ductules, as old name for which vasa deferentia. And what are deferentia? These ductules pass from the upper part of the testis into the head of the epididymis. Within the head, these tubules become highly convoluted. The head of the epididymis is in fact nothing but a mass of a convoluted tubule at the lower end of the head of the epididymis. Then, head of the epididymis, these tubules end in a single tube called as the duct of the epididymis. The body and tail of the epididymis are formed by convolutions of this duct. At the lower end of the tail, duct of epididymis become continuous with the ductus deferens. The microscopic structure of the seminiferous tubule show both types of cells present in the seminiferous tubule. The cells for the spermatogenesis and cells for the other secretions. Spermatogenesis, these cells are spermatogonial linkage and supporting cells, cells of the Sertoli. Spermatic cells and the spermatic cells and the cells of the Sertoli. The cells of the Sertoli, they are also parenchymal cells. Then the cells of the spermatogonial lineage are the spermatogonia that are close to the basement membrane of the seminiferous tubule. These divide mitotically and give the primary spermatocytes to undergo first and second mitotic division to form the secondary spermatocytes and spermatids, and respectively spermatids change into spermatozoa. So lastly, seminiferous, the basement membrane of the seminiferous tubule produces spermatozoa, and the Sertoli cells and the other supporting cells, they are responsible to secrete the hormone, testosterone and other androgens, sex hormones. The sartoli cell protect and nourish the developing the germ cells. Okay, now the epididymis is a comma-shaped structure situated along the lateral part of the posterior border of the testis. It consists of head, body and tail. The blood vessels, testicular artery, a branch of the abdominal artery, you may say a gonadal artery, and the right testicular vein open directly into the inferior vena cava, while the left opens into the internal external iliac vein. Then this is one of the gonad. Enlargement or the inflammation of the testis is called as a orchitis. So there may be infection to the testis, that is called as a orchitis. Then see, there may be accumulation of water in the layers of the testis, especially in the tunica albuginea and tunica vaginalis, and that leads to the enlargement or a formation of water and enlargement, inflammation and enlargement of a testis, that is called as a hydrosis. These are the three clinical. I again revise, the inflammation of the testis is called as a orchitis. The orchitis may be the result of the mumps. Mumps may result in the inflammation of the testis, and the in a family planning, the vas is being cut off, vas deferens is being cut off, not to pass the sperm cells, spermatozoa, into the semen. So that is the intention to do the family planning. That is called as a vasectomy. Vasectomy, it is nearer. The duct that is coming from the testis is being cut off and is not allowed to carry over the sperm cells into the normal semen. That these are the main important issues related with the applied anatomy point. The functions of the testis, the function of this, all of this. Sartoli cells, they are non-proliferative form of cell called as a sustentacular cells. Typically, they are tall, slender and irregular columns. Then, the we have seen the interior in a TS, mediastinal testis and the rectus testis. How many lobules are there? 200 to 300. And each of the seminiferous tubules, there are at the basement membrane, there are the cells which produce spermatozoa, and other supporting cells, they produce the hormonal secretions like testosterone and androgens, or the sex hormones, you may say. So, main important functions, secretion, mainly the functions of the testis is to produce the spermatozoa. Secondly, it produces testosterone and androgens and progesterone at some amount. Then it also responsible to secrete the androgens or the sex hormones, secondary sexual characters by which it develops the secondary sexual character. Then the it also support nourishes the spermatogonial cell, that is spermatozoa, or the stages of the spermatogenesis. All the cells are nourished by the testis. Then the phagocytic in nature, hence they act as a macrophages. Then the space between the seminiferous tubule is filled by loose areolar connective tissue containing blood vessels and modified epithelial cells. They are called as a interstitial cells of the Leydig cell, just we have seen. The interstitial cells of the testis, main important function of the interstitial cells of the testis, they are, just I have told, they are responsible to secrete the hormones, testosterone and secondary sexual character cells, they are the androgens. So, examination of a hydrocele is done by in a dark room by passing the red light into the scrotum, and the testis is being visualized in a dark room by the torch. and that is the examination of the testis. And keep in mind, the testis is never in a one horizontal plane. One of the testis is always lower, and one is always above. They do not remain at a one horizontal plane togetherly. Either right testis will be down or the left testis will be down in a layers of the testis. 2 mark question: the layers of the testis, weight of the testis, and it may be asked in the physiology or a physiological point of view as an endocrine organ. Stages of development. This question, this testis spermatogenesis, the spermatid, primary spermatogonia, secondary spermatogonia, and spermatocytes and spermatozoa. These are the stages of development of the spermatogenesis. A full mature spermatozoa is produced, and that is being released via vas deferens. And spermatozoa is one of the important component in the semen for the fertilization with the ovum. That spermatozoa gets fertilized with the ovum. Then the process of spermatogenesis requires a temperature. See, testis is an abdominal organ basically. It during in the intrauterine life, it comes into the bag-like portion called as a scrotum. But unfortunately, if testis do not, that is a called as a process of descending of testis. If it is not descended in the scrotum, the testis remains as an abdominal organ. So testis requires a cold temperature for spermatogenesis. In this condition, if the testis, everything is normal, but testis are abdominal organ in an adult life, and in such person there is no possibility of the spermatogenesis, because testis require cold temperature, and in such cases the failure of embryonic descent of the testis is produces sterility in male and known as a cryptochidism. Then the hypersecretion of gonadotropic hormone leads to testicular atrophy, which manifests the enucism. This enuch, excessive functioning. Then the Pollock syndrome or Klinefelter syndrome, they are two important syndromes characterized by the hypogonadism in adolescent men. They don't the gonads are not the gonadal characters of the gonads are not well developed, or there may be atrophy of the testis. These are the main important point regarding the testis. So you may describe a separate epididymis, tubules that lines the columnar, the basement membrane produce spermatozoa, and other cells, the supporting Sertoli cells, they are responsible, the Leydig cells, they are responsible to secrete the hormonal cells. So these are the some two marks question we have discussed, 2 to 3 marks per weight of the testis, layers of the testis. The functions of the epididymis are the phagocytosis of a defective sperms, then the concentration of a semen by water absorption from it. Functions of the epididymis: then it secretes glycoproteins, that is salicylic acid, glycerol phosphatase, and which are essential for the maturation of the spermatozoa. Then the basal cells, these are the small rounded polyhedral cells found in between the bases of the tail of the columnar principal cells. The basal cell are believed to be the stem cells which give rise to the pseudo stratified columnar cells. Then the vas deferens, it is a stellate lumen. What is vas? Vas is a stellate lumen lined by the pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium, thick muscle coat
inner longitudinal, middle circular, and the outer longitudinal layer. The ductus vas deferens is a long elongated tube-like structure originates with the continuation of the epididymis. Epididymis continues as a vas, and both the vas lastly opens into the second part of the urethra for the ejection of the semen. The TS of the deferens, vas deferens, shows first in interiorly mucosa. Mucosa consists of the stellate. It is stellate in shape. You know, the mucus, the urethra, male urethra, the shape of the male urethra. Then the outer is a muscular coat. This is the prominent, consists of the inner longitudinal, middle circular, and outer longitudinal muscle coat. Then the outermost layer of the vas is a tunica adventitia. It is outermost layer made up of the dense irregular connective tissues with blood vessels and nerve fibers embedded in it. And important functions of the vas deferens, it is the powerful contractions of the muscle coat makes sperm to move towards the ejaculatory duct. Adventitial layer is protective and supportive in function. The pseudostratipedicolumnar epithelium lining the mucosa both secretory and absorption of absorptive functions. These are the main important points regarding the vas deferens. So you have a lot more chance. Vas, seminiferous tubule, and testes. The layers of the testes. You may draw the diagram of a TS of the testes separately, and the microscopic structure of the testes showing the seminiferous tubules. Thank you.